got the epic pre-battle music going. You guys can go ahead and drag your tokens to where you are. This is where the troglodytes are kind of lined up. Now, I know what you're thinking.
I can't
There's
see
only... You're thinking, I can't see anything. Go ahead and drag your tokens. Go ahead and just drag your tokens into the darkness. You should see something there.
Ah, yes. There we go.
My token.
Yeah, I see no tokens.
You can drag your from your character sheet onto the map.
Yeah, your character sheet. Didn't work, maybe. Okay, fine. I'll do it myself.
Oh, that didn't work.
I apparently have a token now, but I can't see anything.
How do I drag my character sheet? I want to know for the future.
Just, you just click on your character and bring it.
Also, I didn't mean to mention this, but my health points are linked on my token to my character sheet, but my magic points are not.
They're not? It says they are.
No.
So where's the walls?
I think it's to the south of us.
Yep, to the south.
Hey, why does Harmony glow so much better than I do? That's unfair.
I can't see.
So I'm planning to be up on that.
I see two Gorms. He's cloned himself.
Can you see now? You're up in the very left top corner.
It's funny that I have two Gorms.
I currently see a black
square. I still can't see.
Okay, the Gorm near Curiosity, I can't. Doesn't have my light radius.
Yep, I know. You guys have. Ari, how far can you see?
How do I delete a
token? Let me check my powers on that, because it's not on my little thingy, but it should be be 20 feet.
Since I'm eating Gorm.
Yeah, I forgot. Yeah, some of your tokens are broken. Oh, if it's 20 yards, then you should see 60 feet.
I just know it's dark sight. I can't remember what exactly it was. Let me look
at it. It's 60.
Yeah. It's whatever dark sight is.
Yep. I have it at 60.
I didn't delete the two, so for a minute you could see 260 feet away.
Nice!
Yeah.
The whole map.
I could go for that.
Hope you studied really fast on that.
Okay. So let me explain the mechanics, because this is kind of going to be a big deal. So, as you can probably notice, there aren't 144 trogs on the map. Well, there's a reason for that. That would be a stupid amount of NPCs for me to take care of.
Obviously, they're fighting on other sides of the walls. And other sections.
No, they're all here.
Oh.
But each one of the... There's 12 of the tokens. Each one of them represent 12... trucks. So, and the enemy tokens will be the same way. They will represent 12 of the enemy. Except for specific ones, which you'll know when you see them. So, basically, that what that means is that each of these tokens have basically have, they have hit points equivalent of 12 troglodytes or enemies. However, they will not, also will, depending on who they're attacking, they will do the equivalent damage of 12. So if they attack each other, they'll do an equivalent damage of 12. However, if they're attacking you, they'll do an equivalent of 1-on-1. So if you get swarmed by 12, by like 3 troglodyte, or 3 enemy tokens, it doesn't mean you're getting 3 dozen trogs on you. It's just meaning like, you know, you're going to get, it basically just means you're getting 3 attacks on you from individual trogs, but also that that group of those 3, not trogs, enemies, you know what I'm saying, is going to, is crowding around you. It's just representative of each of them. Tokens obviously don't represent a dozen or more, are obviously your own tokens and tokens like chief and leader, which you can see. Any questions?
Yeah, before the battle started, could I do the thing where I like spend 15 minutes to like swap out one of my spells?
Yes. Any one of you that is a spellcaster, you may do that to prepare for battle. So this is at this point. So chief and leader have the trogs lined up. And you can tell Harmony, you especially being having a military background, they have no tactics. They are very, this is a very tribal warfare, and they are basically lining up to challenge whatever threat comes. They do seem to be organized as far as this is a fighting style that they're all familiar with, but you can think about like directing them in a certain way, but it might be difficult for them to understand that. Just giving you a heads up.
Okie dokie, I gotta be real convincing. Gotta tell Gold Leader to tell them.
Oh gosh.
Well, what's the terrain like? Is it all flat? Are there hills? What's it look like?
So for the most part, it looks like this. You see things like that and that. Those are hills. Those are hilly terrain. It's for the most part, it's dunes. You are traveling on dunes, which when you step, you can sink in. Some places you sink into about ankle deep, others can be about knee deep. It's just kind of odd. So it is considered difficult terrain. Although, something else you're noticing, that trogs don't seem to have a problem traveling through it. This little like snake thing here, that's the road. That's the road leading to Zagahta. And yes, Zagahta is to the south of this map.
Cool. Okay.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm reading something. So on the Songwood crossbow that I have, it says reload minor action. Is that supposed to be that way? Because great, most crossbows are major actions.
Yep, it is. It for this crossbow, it is a minor action.
Okay, time to change that.
It's part of what makes this bow special.
Yeah, so that's what my thinking is, having somewhat like going down to the south and letting the enemy attack us, and then having some of us with the troglodytes who are hiding behind the hill and waiting for the enemy to come past and kind of attack them from the side / behind. Any thoughts?
That sounds good, actually.
Well, Linda is flying around checking to make sure they don't attack from another direction.
We cannot hear you.
No?
I heard
no?
Christian Gamer just posted it in the other thing.
Oh, I posted that earlier.
Oh, is this another one? Oh, you were typing again. Oh, that's what it was. I saw you.
Yeah,
I saw you typing again, and then I saw something show up, and then.
I was just gonna say I can't see anything still, but.
Oh, sorry.
So I'm gonna hide myself down.
So can Vinda, this ridge.
Can Vinda
turn into a tiny little owl or something that can see in the dark better, maybe? There are tiny owls.
Yeah, I just don't know what their stats are. Let me look. You can't, you know, you can't cast spells in a shapeshift form, right?
Well, she's keeping a lookout first.
It's fine. I'm just letting you know that ahead of time.
And she'll have to turn back to fate.
Also, I'm gonna roll stealth.
Is there any forest area by any chance around us? I doubt it, but.
No, I don't think there's a forest area within like 300 miles.
Okay. Alright, then never mind.
Eric, do you want to.
They do have lemons somehow. Somewhere.
Well, I figured, you know, fall little trees. Maybe we can fudge and call the forest.
That would take some serious lawyering.
Okay, anyway. Aerie, do you want to see if... I think you and Chieftain seems like he has a greater handle on tactics. Take that 2/3 of the forces, hide behind that hill. I'll stay with Leader and the rest of them. We'll go farther south. Wait until the enemy comes down to attack us, and then you attack from behind.
That sounds like a plan. Which hill are you talking about, though? Just ping it on the map.
This big one that's by the path over there. I think some of us should stay with you, some of us should stay with me. I don't know who should stay where. I think Gorm should definitely stay with you.
Considering his particular tactics in fighting, he probably range at least him and probably Brendel or Bramble should stay with me.
I would agree.
We should create a defensive position. Entrench ourselves. Use the trogs to hold them back while we rain arrows on them.
Yeah, well, not all of us are using arrows, so if you stay behind the group that's going to be hiding behind the hills once they engage, you can fire arrows from behind them. Alright, so that would leave me, Winter, and Curiosity in the front group.
What about Curiosity?
Just stay next to me.
That is how it seems.
Alright, you want to try and see if we can explain this to the Chieftain?
I will try.
I'll be here if you need help.
And Ari will walk up to the Chief. Chief, my friend and I were considering putting some of your warriors over there by that wall, over there by that hill, so that we could create a pincer attack, using kind of a two-pronged attack to bait the enemy into us and to spring a trap, as it were.
You kind of squints at you. Leader was right. You use many, 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 many words.
Here, I'll simplify it. All right. You and 2/3 of your warriors are going to go with Airy behind the hill. You're going to wait for the enemy to come past you when they attack the rest of us with Leader and myself. When Airy gives a signal, you all go out and attack.
You want us to hide behind the hill and then attack later?
It's so you can attack them from behind and catch them by surprise. Their weapons will be pointing in the wrong direction.
Maybe. Leader, what do you think? Sneaking up sounds sort of cowardly. Trog no like cowards. Trog is strong and brave.
The enemy doesn't know how many of you are here, so if they think that that's all you have, it will be better.
But this is all we have.
Well, if you hide some of them, they won't see everyone.
Roll communication persuasion.
Oh dear. Come on, 20. Or nat 18, I guess. Nope. Oh, I got a stunt point. What can I do with a stunt point? Oh no, I don't have my rulebook open because I came late and I was not prepared.
Isn't there a reroll persuasion? Is that one or two stunt points?
Hold on a second.
You can tag the perfect witty remark onto the end social. Of your action.
It is like what page is it on?
It is like this, Chief.
Like 79.
I have two weapons, and I will draw out both my weapons and hide my sword behind my back. If the enemy thinks you have this to fight with, and I'll hold up my dagger in the offhand, then they don't see what is behind the back. Where the real threat lies.
Or persuasion.
Can't do worse than... Okay, I guess you could technically do worse than me, but...
No, I want him to do worse. Nope.
Not with an ability of 3 and a focus in it.
I mean, if you rolled all ones, it'd be a critical fail.
And that might
while demonstrating your technique, you cut your hand off with your sword. Also, if he'd rolled all ones, then it would have been lower than your roll.
Can I roll my persuasion?
For what?
To try to convince him that it would be a good idea because it's not coward, it's smart.
You'll have to say it to him.
That was the chief, right?
Well, you're talking to both, but yeah, you can direct it to the chief.
Chief, attacking from the back is not coward. It would be a smart thing to do, and you are very smart.
Okay, go ahead and roll. He kind of strokes his lizard chin, though it doesn't have a beard. Maybe big folk are right, Leader. They fight differently than Trogs. Trog just fight other Trogs, and Trogs fight animal. Trogs not fight lady. Maybe they know how to fight lady. Leader kind of keeps his arm crossed and a little bit of a frown, but he nods respectfully to Chief. Fine, but Trug lead other Trugs in front. We not hide. You hide. Not leader.
As you wish.
All right. So what did you, where, what do you want and moved and where?
I believe Kylar wanted 2/3 of the troglodytes back behind this rock over here.
Over where Gorm is, but like kind of in front of where Gorm is, yeah. So that'd be 8 of the, because there's 12 of them, yes. Yeah, and then the other one's kind of down where I'm standing. How far away from the wall are we standing?
You're about a good 200 feet from it.
Cool.
Well, we're further from the wall than I would have thought.
I mean, it's a big open sand dune. You can stand where you like. I mean, this the map itself won't shift, but you can tell me where you're at.
Well, I would imagine we'd want to be up near against the wall so that they can shoot arrows from the wall at things.
I mean, I guess I shouldn't say it won't shift. I mean, this is the position where the hills are. There aren't as many hills the further you go back.
Yeah, I mean, if we can always fall back if things are going poorly.
Alright, anyone else want to make any last changes? I mean, when the battle starts, this is where you're going to be, so I would move your token where you want to be before it starts.
I'm flying around to make sure we're not flanked. So I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing as far as position on this map.
Well, if you're flying around to make sure we aren't flanked, I'd be watching like this area.
I don't know where you're indicating.
You can't see the pings on the map? From that general side.
Well, I was kind of meaning that to make sure they don't come from another direction entirely towards the town.
Okay, then are you keeping an eye out?
Yeah.
Go ahead and get me a perception roll.
I already did my stealth roll, but I'm basically prone on the hill looking over it, watching for things.
I also want to tell the Trogs, like, in the groups over here, I try to get their attention, and then I say, If you see a glowing ball of shiny appear in your midst, one of you should carry it with you.
What?
I have like a healing ball spell, but they have to carry it with them, so I'm just going to tell them if they see a shiny thing, they should carry it.
You see several of them sort of look between each other. You hear again whispers of, what is glowing? Go ahead and roll an intelligence check for me.
And Jeffery would like to use stealth.
Okay, go ahead and roll. Curiosity, as you hear them whispering, you are, and been hearing this several times, you are slowly reminded that they can't tell the difference between light and dark, so they may not be able to know what glowing or light is.
What? But they know what shiny is.
Right, but your spell is mostly light. Like, they might be able to see the orb, but I'm just saying you're maybe, I'm giving you a hint, you're maybe not describing it in a way that they're going to be able to understand.
Okay, yeah.
I think his objection was, if they know what shiny is literally something reflecting light.
That's what you how you define shiny.
This is true.
Okay, curiosity attempts again. If you see a ball appear that's hovering in the air, someone should grab it and carry it with them. Like a giant yellow squishy. If you see a giant floating yellow squishy in the air, grab it.
Several of them kind of perk up and nudge each other. Yes, looking for yellow squishy. I.
I'm not quite sure that went through the way you intended.
If you see a giant lemon in the air trying to aid you, then... No, sorry. I don't actually say that pun.
As Jeffery has a stunt point, can he use Stay Awake?
Sure.
Oh wow, I just noticed what that roll, what his stealth roll was.
Go ahead and roll initiative for yourself and then add it to the turn order. Just prepping things for now.
For when we all die.
Exactly.
I'll look at Bramble. Bramble, are you sure you want to stand just out there?
Where should I move to?
I don't know. You fight mostly using bows, right?
Correct.
I think maybe if you were up by Gorm over there behind the hill, that would probably be the best spot.
Yeah, Jeffery can hold his own over there.
I'll make sure he's safe.
Thank you. What do I roll for Jeffery for the Stay Awake?
That was his stunt?
Correct.
Is that under Exploration?
That's under Combat Sense, it says. I'm supposed to do a TN 11 perception test with a focus of your choice. If you succeed, the GM may tell you something about the battlefield. Good luck telling Jeffery something about the battlefield.
Okay, then just go ahead and roll a TN 11 check then. So you need to get an above an 11 for perception. Oh, you're talking about stay aware. Okay.
The perception.
Make a TN11 perception chest with a focus of your choice. Yeah, so go ahead and roll perception. If he has a focus in perception, he can roll that with it.
He does not.
Okay. He is 11. So he makes it. So actually, funnily enough, Jeffery is aware at the same time as Vinda is of the spooky army coming up from the north. How and if he can even communicate that to you, I have no idea. But Jeffery is aware of it.
Okay, where north is where?
So I'm pinging Vinda.
Yeah.
What? So Vinda.
You pinged me, I think. Okay.
Yep, Vinda. As you are flying above, keeping an eye out, you start to hear noise, chants, it sounds like laughter, hideous laughter coming towards you, and you see coming up. The Old Luth Army.
As I have 2 stat points, I'm going to use defense stance.
Oh, wait, are these your stunts from initiative?
Actually, that was... Yes, I'm sorry, that was from initiative, so I can't do that, can I?
Nope. So initiative stunts don't...
Right, it was just combat. Yep.
All right. Here we go. Vinda, you see the creatures emerging. They seem to be running through the sand at a very, very quick pace. And you can see something large kicking up dust behind them. But they all seem to be coming from the same direction. You haven't seen anything else flying and coming in any other direction. But they are barreling down on your position.
Okay, so they're coming from the direction expected.
Yep.
I will dash back to... others.
Okay.
And since that used both the both my major and minor to run and move, I don't think I can turn back yet. yeah, I end up around there.
Okay. So now we're gonna start the initiative order. So first up is leader. But yes, on the turn order, he is known as Lieutenant Gelgax, which if you have ever asked for his name, that's what it would have been. But that's leader. He kind of steps up in front of everyone. And you see as he steps up, Harmony, you see what looks to be sort of like an orangish glow curls up from his arm, and it seems to come into his chest and pulsate. And you see what looks to be like vigor coming into him, some sort of magic. And you hear like the sound of a coyote almost come from his lips as he just kind of like, oh, into in front of his men. And then he raises up his two-handed sword with his in his hand, and he says, "Trog, brave! Trog, fight! Trog, win!" And the other trogs behind him all raise up their spears and say, "Lead our lead! Lead our lead!" And that's gonna be his turn. Binda.
I will turn back into myself and, they're coming.
Gorm?
I will take the prepare minor action.
Okay. Harry?
I'm going to see if I cannot hide a little bit. Do they look like they've actually spotted me or any of the trogs over here?
You can't tell.
Okay. Yeah, in that case, I'm going to go ahead and stealth up. Take a low position next to the wall and try to hide, as it were.
Alright. And roll.
And 6 stunt points. Great.
You think yourself sufficiently hidden.
Who's going for Chief Odaling, or is that me? Because
no, I'm going for him.
Okay, good. Because I'm like sitting here trying to figure out what I could have spent points on, but probably nothing.
Yeah, I have to do this. Now comes the time where I gotta think about what everyone's gonna do.
Okay.
Well, you're the GM. You got yourself into the situation.
Yeah, she's leading two armies against each other. She's playing both sides of the chessboard.
Okay. Most of the troglodytes, except the one near Airy, and Guarm and Bramble. Area, unfortunately, you're out of the area of effect. But each of you, the all of you, and Area, you notice this. You see Gorm and Bramble, your weapons, whereas before, you know, you had your weapons readied. You see them now, and you see Chief Odalip close his eyes. He places two fingers in front of his face, directly in front of his nose, and closes his eyes for a moment. And you see him mutter something, and then he whips his arm with the down in front of you all, and you see lightning crackles from his fingers, and as it shoots out to each of you, and you watch the lightning, instead of hitting you, it catches onto your weapons, and you see that each of your weapons and a vast amount of the troglodytes around him, your weapons all begin to crackle with lightning energy. And they crackle and sizzle and go back up and down the weapon, but don't seem to do any harm to you. It doesn't feel any different, but you can definitely tell that something's been changed to your weapon. So, for the duration of the entire encounter, for 1 minute, which will be math.
10 rounds.
10 rounds. Thank you. Which will be for 10 rounds. Every time you hit, you inflict damage, you will inflict an additional 3 points of penetrating damage to the enemy. So, lots for me to think about, so try and keep that in mind when you attack. But for Bramble and Gorm, that should help you out.
Is that extra 3 points of piercing?
Yes. And then he takes his staff and he stamps it into the desert and looks and sort of and calls out to his fellow troglodytes. Trogs brave! Trogs win! Trogs brave! Trogs win! And you hear the trogs repeating his chant. Okay. So, for these troglodytes, you see they start kind of coming up closer on you. Sort of inching their way past y'all. You see, as they kind of chant, they're coming up behind their leader to support him. These other trogs, Harry, this one comes closer to you. Some of these others kind of cling to the wall, but they get a little bit closer as they kind of eagerly anticipate the battle. Gonna be their turn because you guys didn't order them to do anything else. So, Jeffery.
Jeffrey's just gonna try to go stealth.
Didn't you already roll stealth for him?
Yeah, but you didn't say it was successful or not, so I didn't think he passed.
Well, he already rolled for stealth, so he is as stealthy as he thinks he is.
Okay. Then he'll just kind of sit there.
Okay.
Hidden.
Curiosity.
I will attempt to summon my water whip. Okay, and then I will fly into the air. Just hover where I'm standing.
Okay. Harmony.